give life to those that have it. Wisdom is the ability to make a difference. Mm-hmm. Praise God. Mm-hmm. That's what God gave him, wisdom. So the advice of Joseph was good. Amen. So our advice, when the excellent spirit of God is on us, our advice, our good advice will be good. People will understand. People will appreciate our contribution. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Maybe your place of work, you have spent years there. And people don't, you have been contributing, doing your work. And you see people who are the little to it, they recognize them and appreciate them. You that have, you work hard, you try and do, they don't see you. Amen. But the spirit of excellence will be upon us today.
Amen.
So anytime you contribute,
amen,
in any areas, people will know that something is happening.
Amen.
And they will appreciate you for it.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Said he was made second in charge over all Egypt by Pharaoh. Praise God.
Amen.
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 One of the achievements, you now have the ability to what? Interpret dreams.
Mm-hmm.
You can interpret dreams. Amen.
Amen.
So God instantly make him senior advisor to Pharaoh.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
So the advice was good, senior advisor to Pharaoh. And God look at it, no, that position is not enough. God had to make him the second man in a foreign land.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
So, children, your color will not intimidate you.
Amen.
Your color is, will not prevent you from being anything in this country.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you are focused, you will be there.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
If you go to the hospital, there's black doctor, there's white doctor. They treat the same way. Amen. They give you the same. There is no black injection. There is no white injection. Amen. The Lord will help us in Jesus. All right. He said he was certain it was not his brother that sent him to Egypt, but God. Amen. Another achievement of Joseph. Joseph was certain who is sending him to what? To Egypt. So when you are praying, did you pray for your brother to die? Amen. Our brother is not our enemy. Joseph knew that his brother is not his enemy. And he knew that his brother is not the one that is sending him to what? To Egypt. Amen.
Amen.
And God will give all the spirit to design,
amen,
so that you know what is happening.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. So our sister mentioned this morning that God, the children of God, God will teach us how to forward, fight. There is a way the children of God fight.
Amen.
Amen. There is a right way to fight.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
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 Genesis 15 verse 20. I want someone to read there. Genesis 15, verse 20. How Joseph was setting.
But as for you, ye do evil against me.
Mm.
But God meant it unto it to bring to pass, as it is this day, to save much people alive.
Praise God.
Amen.
Did you see that? As for you, what you think is just to finish me, you don't want to see me again. But the plan of God is to what? Send me ahead of you to go and prepare.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So let me connect that with Jesus now, as our brother has said. Amen.
Amen.
And Jesus said, it's better that I go.
Amen.
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 In my father's house, there are many mansions.
Amen.
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 He said, I will go and prepare a place for you.
Amen.
And Joseph is saying, it's not you that is sending me there. Is God that is sending me there so that God will go and prepare me,
amen,
to do what? Deliver you. Praise God. Amen.
Amen.
Pray that the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
All right, outline two. We'll have time to take some questions. Lesson from the life of Joseph. Now, as a child of God, what do you learn from the life of Joseph? Lesson from the life of Joseph.
He was able to manage his sources.
Praise God.
Without learning anything distracting or...
Amen. That's wonderful. So, I want us to answer it like this. Let's go try and personalize it to ourselves. Okay? What you learn from the life of Joseph?
Forgiveness.
Forgiveness. Praise God. That's powerful. Forgiveness. Amen.
Focus.
Amen. Joseph was what? Focus. Amen. And the Bible said, he look unto the heap. Where is the what? Help coming from? The help coming from no one. Not even the brothers and sisters, not even the father. But what? From God. So the focus of God, the focus of Joseph was on God.
And do what is pleasing to God, regardless of the circumstances.
Amen. Do you see that? Do what is pleasing to God. Amen. And the Bible said, in all situations, give him thanks. Appreciate him. Just imagine somebody from sold him to slave, from there, servant, from there there was conspiracy against him. They sent him to prison. Praise God. Not one day in prison, not 2 days, not months, years in prison. Praise God. And he was focused on God. Amen. I believe some of us spend 5 days now. You see, people start complaining. God, where are you? As if God is hiding from them. God will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Yes.
What I also learned from that is that we should always be filled with the Spirit, you know, because everything that Joseph did or said, it was because of the Spirit. Even Pharaoh himself said, can we find a man such as this in whom the spirits of the gods dwell? So whatever Joseph did, accomplished, he did it because he was full of the Spirit of God.
Praise God.
Amen.
The excellent Spirit of God was in him. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
He was also diligent in his work, whether
praise God. What? Diligent in his work. Praise God. Amen. He was what? Diligent in his work. Wherever you are working, make sure you don't cheat the company. Praise God. Not with time, not with 5 minutes. Praise God. That is how to live a principle life. You must be what? Diligent in your work. If you are not diligent in other people's work, there is no way you will have your company that you will succeed. Praise God. Amen. You have to be committed. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Alright. Lesson from the life of Joseph. Be humble. He was humble. God sometimes brings adversity and trials into our lives to teach us humility. Praise God. Do you understand that? So anything can happen. So don't, whatever is happening in the world, God don't look at the way you look at things. And if this one happen, what will people say? God don't care about that. God is saying, for my name's sake. Amen.
Amen.
God can turn into good. God can turn into good any evil that people do against you. Amen. God can turn into good any evil that people plan against you.
Amen.
We saw that one from Genesis chapter number 15, verse 20. Amen.
Amen.
I also understand the book of Esther. And the Bible said, things gallons of death were prepared by Haman to you to hang Mordecai. Praise God. When that happened, God turned it. Amen. Mordecai was now what? Appreciated and exalted and promoted. What happened to Haman? They replaced him. They used the same hammer that is that the same gallons of death that he prepared. They used it to hang him.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
I pray this morning.
Amen.
That whosoever that dig a pit for you,
Amen.
They will fall into it.
Amen.
In the name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
What the Bible said in Proverbs chapter number 27 verse 26.
Amen.
He explained to us. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
All right. Say, okay. Hold on to integrity no matter how great the temptation and fierce opposition appears. Stay loyal and obedient to God. Genesis 39:9-12 explain that. Let's read Psalm. Psalm 119:11. Keep your integrity. Hold on to God no matter the situation. Amen.
Amen.
Don't change anything. Amen. Don't change your attitude. Don't change your character. Don't change the way you behave. If you are a child of God, you are focused in all situations. The Bible said, in every situation, be thankful unto Him. Because that is the will of God concerning you. Amen. The will of God concerning us is what? To be thankful. Whether it's sweet, praise God. Amen. So, in every circumstance, in every situation, if it is secular world now, our Father in the Lord and our mommy, they will be grieving now. Pain, things, all those, you know, the situation. But because they have the power of God in them, amen, it makes them to understand the situation. Praise God. People can look at it. I look at it that not a pastor losing his son. I look at it the father losing his son. Let the pastor first. The pain that will be there, the father losing his son. Praise God. And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And God will strengthen them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
All right. Are we there? Psalm.
Thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee.
Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
Who's saying that? What should we have in our heart?
The
word of God. The only thing that tells you don't do that is the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen?
So the Holy Spirit of God cannot stay in you if you don't have the word of God in you.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God.
Amen?
Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Because the Holy Spirit needs the word of God to function.
Amen.
We understand from the beginning, he said the word, the Spirit of God was hovering on the surface of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
But in another way, I think the Holy Spirit was doing nothing. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
And the Bible said, God said, let there be light.
Mm.
And the Holy Spirit held the word of God and take the word of God and brought light into existence.
Mm.
So the Holy Spirit needs the word of God in us.
Amen.
To do something. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Write down your God-given vision. This one will empower us also. Write down your God-given vision, dreams or plan. Pray over it and be wisely guided in sharing it with others. Amen.
Amen.
Children, also be careful. You don't share your plan anyhow.
Yes.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Not everybody are happy with your plan the way you are going. So you don't share it anyhow.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Because the way Joseph was, chose his dream, tell his dream to his brothers, to his father, and he what? What did he do? He brought hatred. He brought pain. Amen.
Amen.
I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God will help us. God will guide us.
Amen.
Be God-ward dependent. I mean, many men of God have lived this stage now. Praise God. You can see men of God coming to our town and be using, I will build the city. You don't build anything, it's God.
Yes.
Don't give yourself a credit. You that will sleep today, you don't know whether you get up tomorrow.
Like,
my friend, don't give yourself credit. Then you are missing it. most men of God might not make heaven, not because they sin, because of pride. Amen. Not because of because they commit sin or the other way, because of pride. They are standing in the position of God in the life of people. And in another way, some followers are pushing their general overseer to miss heaven, just like the follower of Moses pushing him to miss promised land. They push him. Amen. We have to be careful and be praying for them. Praise God. Be God what? Dependent. Always acknowledge God at the source of your achievement and never take any credit for it. Don't take credit. I built this. I do this. I made this. I made this in Europe. Go to the cemetery. People that are better than you, they are in the cemetery sleeping. Yes.
Yeah.
If you go to the cemetery, you have professors, you have doctors, scientists. They are there, lying down, doing nothing. Praise God.
Yeah.
Amen. But when you are alive, you should know that it's not by your power.
Amen. Amen.
If you can get up, you drink tea, go to the hospital and see people, they hang their leg.
Mm-hmm.
Who is feeding with pack? You know that God is great.
Yes.
Praise God.
Amen.
No, you can't explain it if you are not being in that position. Amen. I have spent over two months in the hospital. Mm. I was feeding in pipe. So I know the situation.
Amen.
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 God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Manage success. When God honor you with success and prosperity, you must not forget to honor him and honor others. Amen.
Amen.
Our mommy just said forgiveness and one of the lessons that she learns from Joseph's story.
Mm.
Amen. Mm. Fully forgive. Set your heart to forgive those around you.
Mm.
Amen. This will heal your relationship and keep your heart free from bitterness and deep rooted resentment from the hurt of the past. Amen.
Amen.
Joseph was able to forgive his brothers and sisters, or forgive the family, because all the family became to Egypt. He forgave them. That is when Joseph became free. Amen.
Amen.
I tell you, before that day, Joseph was not still a free man, because there was bitterness in his heart. There was pain. The moment he forgave his brothers and sisters and he hugged them, he was free. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Forgiveness is sometimes difficult, but it's powerful.
Amen.
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 And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Quickly, I want us to take some question or contribution. Question or contribution on Joseph.
To bring out something about Joseph.
Yeah.
If we are a true call of the Lord, we should expect challenges. Joseph moved from one point to the other, meeting hurdles, challenges, things that can stop him. When some Christians get to that point, they think, I don't think this is God. If it is God, he wouldn't have allowed this to happen.
Yeah.
Like Daddy Gio said, there is different way how to prove his supremacy in our life. So when we come to a point where we feel like this is too much, just raise your hand and surrender to him. Like wherever you are taking me, I'm going. We can see throughout Joseph's life, from one thing to the other, it's enough for Christians to say, oh, this is not God. But still, it's God.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is wonderful. Amen. And we should understand that you can't say that you submitted to God when things are going on fine. When you have cash in your account, you have job, you have shelter, your children, they are yes, everything is probably. You say, yes, I love God, I love God. Amen?
Amen.
You will say you love God if the other thing happened the other way. I don't want to measure it. Praise God. I don't want to measure that, man. Praise God. Amen. You know, people don't want to hear that.
Why?
So Joe's situation is too scary that. Amen. So you don't pray, don't pray with that one. Amen. God can test us in another way. Praise God. Praise God. No, not even with that geo. God be helpful. God know what to do. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. As we said before, God don't need a visa to visit anyone. Amen. If God want to visit, God will visit. But what I'm saying, if God want to test your submission, God will test the things are working well. When you are praising God, I just want God to bless me. Then in another way, you still have, you will use the be powered enough to thank God when something happened. When tears are coming out, we used to be thanking God. That is the problem. Amen. I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Any other contribution? Sir?
I want to talk about potential and values and again training. You know, when you're talking about potentials, you are talking about what do you have in you that you can actually be, that you can develop, that can assist your life to become whom God wants you to be. When you look at the case of Joseph, you know, he has his ability to dream. He was able to develop it. You know, it was the dream that assisted him to be who he eventually became. You know, in our situation where we find ourselves, where some of us, you know, you are in choir department, you are in Sunday school department, you are in help ministry, even as low as it is, you can actually do something that can also make you to be where God wants you to be. Now, I want to talk about values. If you look at the Joseph, you know, he had some challenges, like what our pastor said. You know, he had some challenges, but his values still remain. You know, I'm compelled to say this because I read the story this morning. You know, the story really touched me. It was a story of a little boy that was selling groundnuts, and he took it to a football pitch where they were playing football. You know, two banks were playing together, and the head of one of the banks, that's FCMB, I don't know, First City Monumental Bank in Nigeria. The MD of that bank happened to be there. And they bought a granite of 2,100 naira from the boy. And they wanted to give the boy 10,000 naira. The boy rejected the 10,000 naira, that no, that is his value. That no, if I take this 10,000 naira, what will I tell my parents? Just give me my 2,100. And the MD asked him, go and call your mom for me. And his mom came. He eventually gave this little boy a scholarship to go to school because of what that value.
Yeah.
You understand now? I now want to talk about training. The Bible says, train the child the way he should go when he grows up, he will not depart from it. It is the training of the parent. And when you look at the case of Joseph too, it was the training of his parent, or maybe his dad probably, that did not make him to fall for Potiphar's wife. You know, when he said, you know, the Bible says, flee from every appearances of evil.
Yeah.
When he saw it, what did he do?
He flee.
He didn't stay. Yeah. He didn't try to test it because of his what? Of his value. So when we look at these three things, the potential from the story of Joseph, the values, and the training, they are very, very instructive.
Vital. Praise God. Amen. That is wonderful. Praise God. Amen. Your explanation sound and an economist. Amen. God be help us. So any more contribution? Amen. Amen. Where are the we spend about 4 weeks or even 6 weeks to deliberate on Joseph.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I believe the masters of Joseph in the house is to give us something. At least just throw something to us. Amen. Brother, are you willing to say something? All right. Praise God.
Let me just use this to call us to to midweek service.
Amen.
Because in the midweek service, we crack all this.
Amen.
This matter of Joseph took us a long time, even took us deeper than digging deep.
Yeah.
It is a pleasure and it will be great if we can learn the word of God together.
Amen.
Every Wednesday, 7 o'clock to 8:30. We are on Zoom at the moment. We don't know what will happen next. But at the comfort of your home, you can still learn. You can still join us. So I'm appealing to the church entirely. Every Wednesday, 7 to 8:30. Let's come and learn the word of God.
Praise God. Amen. So the word of God is powerful. If we want to serve God, there's no way you want to serve God without his word. And the Bible said, he honor his word more than his own name. He says of you calling him Father, Father, Father. If you grab the word of God first, God will show up.
Amen.
Amen. And pray that the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Quickly say something to God this morning. Just talk to him. Say, Father, help me. Give me the excellent spirit, the spirit to make a difference, the ability to make a difference. Give me the strength to be focused on you. Empower me, O Lord. Change every foundation that is not working for us. Help us, O Lord. And let holy your name be glorified. Thank you, Father.